Greetings, and welcome to another LGR video that is slightly different from the norm. And that slightly different is going to, in fact, involve this Commander Keen box, or at least what's inside of it, one thing that's inside of it. We're going to be looking at game catalogs from this and other boxes that I have around here. That may sound boring, but I assure you, I say it's not. Why? Well, you know, I was thinking, as a kid especially, and even now, I spent about as much time actually looking at game company catalogs and publishers' catalogs, about as much time doing that as I did actually playing the game. And, you know, there's nothing wrong with that, because I am an optimist sometimes, and optimistically I like thinking that, you know what, I could own everything in this catalog someday. I can dream, right? Now, I'm not saying that's why I have a huge collection nowadays, but these game catalogs are a pretty big reason. So this is just a bit of a relaxed kind of whatever video. We're going to be looking at some catalogs from some interesting game boxes I've got. So let's just take a look at this one. This is one from Apogee, their hottest action games of 1994. I don't think it originally came with this box, mainly because this is a form gen, actually GT Interactive release of Commander Keen, and this is Apogee. And it also has, apparently a ripped off, there was like an address label there. You could order a lot of these catalogs directly from them, and yes, I did that as a kid. I ordered a lot of them. I was a loser. But hey, it was free, and I couldn't afford the games, so I may as well be gifted with the ability to read descriptions from the publisher and developer. So yes, here in this Apogee catalog, looks like we got Rise of the Triads, a new one, Kill Your Enemies, Kill Your Friends. Yes, I'm gonna get my mom to buy me that one. Good old Planet Strike, the sequel to Aliens of Gold, the Blake Stone game. And let's see, I've got those two. Also have Wacky Wheels. Man, that was new back then too. Mystic Towers. This is exciting times for Apogee. 1994, they were well established as a shareware vendor. All of these games were available as shareware in some form or another, either downloadable or you could order discs, you know, CDs. Wacky Wheels, it's a good game. Mario Kart ripoff, but it's a good game. Mystic Towers, not really familiar with that one, but I do own it. Hocus Pocus, that one was pretty cool. At least I remember it being cool. I think it's because I like the game Clyde's Adventure and Clyde's Revenge, and this kind of reminded me of it superficially. And it's a platformer, you know. It had really cool music. Raptor. That's a good one. I still need to get the box for that, but I have the discs around here somewhere. I think the mail order discs from 3D Realms, like 1997 or so. See, that one wasn't a new title at this time, but what? The best title since Doom. What kind of comparison is that? It's a vertically scrolling shooter. Whatever, man. Weird subjective journalists. Oh yeah, there's Aliens of Gold, the first Blake Stone game. Got that too. Alien Carnage, otherwise known as Halloween Harry. Why haven't I reviewed that yet? Oh, I did review Zombie Wars, the sequel to it, so I guess that's why. And of course, Wolfenstein 3D and Spear of Destiny. Those are good stuff. Good stuff. I guess I do own everything in here. Wow, I didn't realize that. Anyway, online with Apogee and upcoming games. I remember accessing the Apogee BBS, actually at a friend's house, because it was like long distance and yeah, I may as well use up their phone line, not mine. Let's see what else is in here. Yeah, I think it looks like Star Gunner and Boppin'. Realms of Friggin' Chaos, heck yeah. And, yay. Well, let's put that one away. Let's go on to somebody else here. I don't have the box to this one, but I do have the discs. And the catalog. This is Jazz Jackrabbit. This is the mail order release from Epic. So you got, all six episodes on floppies here. And then you got the Christmas editions, both of them. You got Holiday Hair, the 94 or whatever Christmas edition, and then Christmas 1995. Yeah, that's really cool. I really, really am happy to have that. Just got that recently. But it also came with this catalog. And I, man, I wish I had an Epic catalog back in the day, because I would have drooled over this really, really ridiculously. Yes. One Must Fall, 2097. Probably my favorite PC-exclusive fighter. One of my favorite fighting games, period. It was just awesome, being able to upgrade your robots and stuff. Man, Leading Edge. Jazz Jackrabbit. Yes. That was the, actually, the manual slash comic book cover art right there. And in fact, I think One Must Fall, this was a poster that you could get if you bought the game from them. A friend had that, and I remember that being the poster. But I never had it, and I was jealous. I wanted to rip it off his wall and, like, beat him so he could not stop me from taking it. I was a mean kid, I guess. I don't know. Anyway, Epic Pinball. Love this game. Oh, this is by the time they had the CD-ROM version here with the extra four tables. And then there was also the Wizard Works release, which had an extra table, African Safari, which sucked. But, whatever. It's cool to see ads for Epic Pinball. I mean, seriously, you never saw this stuff advertised in, like, magazines. But, at least I never did. Tyrion. That's their old logo right here. Look at this. Coming soon from Safari Software. It wasn't even out yet. Yeah, it was before they went with that, like, reversible, upside-down kind of Tyrion logo. Man, I need to review that. Zargon, that's another one I need to review. One of my favorite platformers from Epic. It's one of my favorite PC platformers, period. I don't know. It's just a strange game. How much was that? Was it $30 for Zargon back then? Wow. I don't know how much Jazz was. $49 for the CD. Oh, okay. $39 for the floppies, which I have over there. Well, that's cool. And more great games. Jill of the Jungle, Bricks, Castle of the Winds, and Solar Winds. No relation. I just have the name Winds and the name, the word Winds. Yes. And the Epic Puzzle Pack. I can't quite seem to get this one in the frame. Anyway, Electro Man, Heart Light, and Robbo. Get the full puzzle pack for $35. That's cool. I don't think I ever went to Epic's BBS, although I did get Epic games from BBS's. I always wanted to go to Go Epic on CompuServe. Never had CompuServe, though. Actually, wait, I might have. No, that was Prodigy. Yeah, from Prodigy to AOL. Oh, yes. That was back when they were still in Maryland before they moved to North Carolina. They did a couple years after this, though. This is, what, 95? I think they moved there in 97? Maybe wrong there, but anyway. Here is one of my absolute favorites. Just games and catalogs, actually. It's a SimCity 2000 Special Edition with the nice shiny box with the shiny gold logo and the shiny shininess. Shining. CD. Yes, these continuing adventures of Maxis. That was just so cool, you know? It wasn't just a catalog. These were adventures. this is from Spring 1996. And this one was cool because, I don't know, they just did the artwork nicely in their catalogs. They're all nicely color-coded by depending on what kind of game it was, what kind of product line, you know, Entertainment, Maxis Kids, Maxis Store games, which were like... No, those weren't. There were some others in here that were from other companies that weren't necessarily Maxis. Now, here's one, though. The Mind Warp. Man, I drooled over this game back in the day. And it never got released. They released one promo video of it that was available on some Maxis game. I don't remember what it was. It actually might be this CD-ROM. There was a quick little trailer for it. Looked interesting, but it never happened. And then there was Maxis Fast Plays, which I don't think ever happened either. At least not in this form, because it came with... These were like demos, sort of. It came with the Mind Warp and Full Tilt Pinball's Space Cadet. And then Space Cadet ended up being on Microsoft Plus, coming out for Windows 95, and then it ended up being on a bunch of versions of Windows after that. So maybe that's what happened to Fast Plays. Maybe that was eventually going to, or originally going to come with Windows. Who knows? Never did. Mind Warp never happened. Space Cadet did, though. Thank goodness for Space Cadet Pinball, or else people would have had to been productive back in the day. Sim Tower. Sim Isle. Don't like that one. But Sim Tower is awesome. I should give Sim Isle another try, though. I've never been too fond of it. Maybe it's just because I'm lazy. Full Tilt Pinball. And there's Space Cadet right there. Classic pinball game that everybody friggin' knows, pretty much. Yes, it was a Maxis game. so you got A-Train. Good stuff there. Oh, it's the PlayStation release. New format. $53.95. That's an intriguing price. You know, 50 is not quite enough. 60 is a bit too much. 55 is even pushing it. $53.95 is ideal. Yeah, here's some of the stuff that Maxis sold or distributed, but it wasn't actually by them. You know, these Paul Cézanne and artwork stuff. Volcanoes, Critical Mass. Yeah, there were a few games like that. Redshift 2 was another one that they sold back then. I actually have Redshift 2 because of this catalog. Because when it was in here, it was always in here. Yeah, there it is. Redshift 2. Because of this catalog, I ended up buying it. Anyway, special edition CD. That's what this is. Yes. Yeah. Scenarios, Volume 1. Rare as balls. In fact, I think the only way to get that was to, you know, order it from this catalog. I mean, yeah, it might have been sold in stores, but I never sold it in stores. And it took me forever to find the copy, so that's what I'm blaming it on. New formats for SimCity 2000, Sega Saturn, and PlayStation. The Saturn's more expensive than the PlayStation. Huh. Alrighty then. Poor Saturn. SimCity Classic Deluxe Edition. What the frick is that? Why would they call it the Deluxe Edition? Oh, okay. More extras including the SimCity Classic graphics set. Oh, I have the graphics set, but I don't have one specifically called Deluxe Edition. That's interesting. Sim Life, Sim Health, Sim Classics, Volumes 1 and 2. Good stuff. Compilations. Yay! Yeah, I don't know what any of this crap is, other than Redshift 2. Yeah, a passion for art. More of that. Baseball for Windows. Gift Maker. That's a bunch of weird frick. Max is doing weird stuff. Yeah, so this was the price list. The full price list was in here. You could actually send this off, order things by mail, or order it by phone, or I think maybe you could order it online a little bit. Maybe, I don't know. I never did that. Just got them in stores back then. Marty in the Trouble with Cheese. Heck yeah, voice activated. Zark of the 19. SimTown, Widget Workshop. Truckology. I always wanted to try that just because it had this, like, 3D-looking landscape or whatever. It was probably awful, but, you know, back then it was 3D. I wanted it. Some intriguingly forgotten kids and edutainment software here. Geo Safari, though, that was popular as crap. Zerk's Rainforest. Man, I'd forgotten about that. Wait, Soleil Software? Okay. Yeah, no, I do remember seeing... There was this weird educational store in my local mall that sold that. At least the Rainforest Lab. Then they moved on and they started selling, like, Sim Safari later. I'm like, what is with you guys and your weird Safari stuff? Geo Safari, Learning Safari, Sim Safari. Late 90s Safaris, man. Coming soon, SimCity 2000 Online. Yeah, that's the network edition. Calling it online is not quite the same as it is nowadays. You don't have servers. You can make your own, though. You know, it's peer-to-peer kind of stuff. IP, direct connection, and whatnot. I have a review of that one. SimCopter, I need a review of that one. SimGolf, not Sid Meier's SimGolf. That came later. And, of course, SimPark, which led into SimSafari later. Marty and Where's Morgan. Yeah, never found a copy of that. Challenger. Don't know. No, it was a Mind Warp t-shirt. I wonder if they ever sold those. Looks like you could actually buy them, though, so maybe. The only thing I ever got from this page here is the SimCity card game. I need a... Yeah, I will show that, actually, when I go over the SimCity games before new SimCity comes out, but yeah. Here's an interesting one. This is MechWarrior 2. Now, inside of this one, the catalogs are quite a bit different. They actually came, at least in this original release, they came in these envelopes. So you got Activision's hottest titles. More hot info. So hot. It's hot. Whatever. It's just your games, guys. So, you don't get a traditional kind of catalog, but you do get something that's not the easiest to get out of this friggin' thing. There we go. These are like individual ads. You know, like, just a sheet of paper. Like some crap you'd get in your junk mail. Anyway, eyeglasses. Oh, man. Yeah, so these are like Cyber Shades 3D, I guess. It sucked. I have never used them, but they sucked. Anyway. Multiplayer, BattleTech 3025. And I still need to look into this. I don't know what this is. I never have heard of it until I saw this. Actually just got this box recently. I only had the Pentium edition of MechWarrior before this, and that didn't have all this crap in there for some reason. So yeah, I need to look at this BattleTech 3025, because I like BattleTech stuff. It's cool. And then they're great buys on Activision's hottest. So inside of here, you get like weird little like freaking bumper stickers. Or not stickers, you know, but they look like them. So that's what I call them. This goes this way. Only $29.95 each. These are classic games. And this is the Atari 2600 action packs. These are like the first time I remember seeing like old games being re-released like that, was these action packs. That was pretty cool. Well, that and like Microsoft Return of Arcade and things. So, mid-90s, man. They're like, yeah, you know, it's retro. 10 years ago. Shanghai's Greatest Moments. I guess that would be... I don't know what that is. I guess a compilation of the Shanghai games? That's interesting. Oh, yeah, friggin' NetMech. MechWarrior 2. Paparazzi. Oh, yeah. I'll play that. Be a douchebag with a camera. So, yeah, I don't know why they did this individual ad thing like this. It's interesting, though. It's like, here's just an ad for the different versions of Pitfall. Whatever. I mean, that's cool. Why not just make a catalog then? Here's another one. Here's Pitfall the Mayan Adventure. So, you know, you couldn't say that in this one. It's, whatever. Power Hits BattleTech. I have that somewhere. Actually, it's over there to the left of me. Yeah. Came with the old MechWarrior 1 and the couple BattleTech games that they made back in the late 80s. There's Shanghai's Great Moments again. Yeah, that's definitely a different, like, more enhanced version of Shanghai. Reviewed Dragon's Eye before or whatever. Need a hint? Pay lots of friggin' money to call hint lines. Man, hint lines were expensive. What the crap? It's a ridiculous idea nowadays. I mean, you know, seriously. You just go online and find stuff on GameFAQs or wherever, YouTube. Not back then. You had to pay. I remember I had a friend who did that in, like, Nintendo. Getting hints or whatever. Ran up a big phone bill, got in trouble. It's hilarious. And there, of course, yeah, you could order stuff. Again, I don't know why they didn't just put this in a catalog. I guess staples were too expensive or something. But, you know, it's Activision. You don't question them. You just accept it. And one more we're going to look at here, and that is the LucasArts catalog from the late 90s. It was from Episode 1 Racer here. And, yeah, this was an interesting time for LucasArts because, you know, they had just released Episode 1. They were really capitalizing on all that stuff. So you had some good games that came out of it. Some. This one was pretty excellent, I thought. But and then, of course, you had all of their old stuff at the same time. So, slightly newer stuff, too. But, yeah, you'll see what I mean by old stuff. But they still sold it, and it was cool. So, it's an interesting time to be a LucasArts fan, I think. So, yeah, X-Wing Alliance. I don't think I ever played that one, but I've got it somewhere. Oh, wow. Yeah, there's all the friggin' games in here. That's a lot of gaming. Friggin' Jedi Knight Dark Forces 2. That's good stuff right there. Rogue Squadron 3D. Man, that game was cool. Oh, yeah. When they started pushing this whole requires 3D acceleration thing, that game's got really cool. But then you still had like the classic style, like Tim Schafer stuff going on too with Grim Fandango. I mean, it was, you know, still 3D, but it wasn't quite like all the other stuff that LucasArts was still doing. So, like I said, an interesting time. And holy crap, man, if I could get a full boxed friggin' Grim Fandango for $30 nowadays, oh man. Sometimes looking at these catalogs just makes me sick. Especially the later part of this catalog. Oh. Yeah, Star Wars Behind the Magic. Huh. I've actually never seen that. Yeah, Curse of Monkey Island. Balls, yeah. It's only $20 too. Jeez. Awesome console lineup. Masters of Terracotta. Nothing like playing as a whore. Is that how he pronounced his name? Such a weird guy. Anyway. Or you can have like Han Solo beat up Chewbacca. What the crap? Herc's Adventures, never played that. Ball Blazer Champions, never played that. Always wanted to though, because I like the original Ball Blazer. X-Wing versus TIE Fighter. Holy crap, that was a good game. X-Wing Collector Series. I have all those individually, so I don't need them. But yeah, includes TIE Fighter, X-Wing, and X-Wing versus TIE Fighter. Oh, sweet stuff. Star Wars Rebellion. Can't say I've ever played that. Huh. Yeah, see, that's the problem. I look through these things nowadays, and I'm like, you know what? I could probably find this game on eBay for like $5 if I look. You know, you end up spending money, but that's cool. I like spending money on old games with big game boxes. And here's their current stuff. Yeah. The Episode 1 game, which wasn't particularly great. Episode 1 Racer, which was pretty awesome. Insider's Guide, who cares? Force Commander, don't think I ever played that. Did that ever even come out? I don't remember, frick. Yeah, LucasArts Sweat Jacket, LucasArts Pimp Hat, and Hanging with LucasArts Key Chain. Yay. Shadows of the Empire is good stuff. At least I remember it being good stuff. Yeah. Been so long since I played a lot of these. And then here you go. You start getting into their older stuff. And man, this just makes me sad. All these old, collections of their older games. I would love to have these collections. Ugh. Or just these original, like, classics here. And they're nice big boxes. I mean, I have a lot of them, but not all of them. I have pretty much all of these here. Except for Yoda Stories. I need to get Yoda Stories. Oh, it was one of those, Windows 3.1 desktop games. It's kind of pointless and kind of dumb, but I remember playing it at somebody's house, and it was cool. Sort of. The Dig. Yeah, this is all of these. Man, I want these. Mortimer. Never played that one at all. Afterlife. I do have that one. There's an Indiana Jones desktop adventures. I have Full Throttle. Still don't have Outlaws. What the crap? Need to get that. But yeah, look at these. $20 for each of them. And then $20 for these. I would pretty much kill for that now. Look at that. Day of the Tentacle. Monkey Island 2. Sam and Max Hit the Road. Air Combat Classics. That's okay. I have those. Indiana Jones. Fate of Atlantis. Look at that. $20. And looks like pretty much original box art and everything too. Oh, that'd just be sweet. And some more junk to make you look like a person. Yay. And the Infernal Machine, which I got that relatively recently, and disappointed to see it's not an adventure game. I mean, it is, but it's like a Tomb Raider clone. Not the kind of adventure I was hoping for. But. And order forms. Yay, for forming orders. Free yo-yo with purchase. Please buy our games. We'll give you a yo-yo. Oh, that's great. Well, I've got a million more catalogs, but this video is going on forever, so I'm going to go ahead and call it right now. If you enjoyed it, well, let me know, and maybe I'll make some more, because like I said, I got catalogs from friggin' everybody. I mean, stuff from Sierra and MicroProse, EA, Rotorbund, on and on and on. I've got a lot of old catalogs. Disney, I think Interplay and Infocom, good stuff. I think I could look at these all day. I do look at them all day sometimes. I mean, seriously, these These catalogs are just cool, and they don't get much attention. So, yes. Well, thanks for watching.